Greetings, everybody, and welcome to my 7 days to die tutorial on Survival 101, how to survive for a week in a zombie apocalypse. So, in the last episode, we managed to finally get our forge up together. Unfortunately, though, it summoned the attention of one very nasty zombie in particular. This is a screamer. Now, screamers will start to scream and summon in zombies. If you don't finish off a screamer quickly enough, she'll start summoning in more. Let's just let her scream a few times and see what happens. So in a minute, she'll scream again, and now more zombies are going to start to be summoned in. We need to finish her off pretty quickly, so let's go ahead and see if we can kill her. So she's the first one you want to target. So let's go ahead and try and get her down, because otherwise she's going to scream a fair few times. There we go, managed to get her down. So the threat has been taken care of for now. However, those screaming zombies can sometimes summon more screamers. If you're particularly unlucky, you'll get a whole chain of them. So that's what happens when you leave your forges and your campfires on for a little bit too long. Now, this guy is a crawler. You want to be careful of him. If he hits you, he can break your legs. So just be careful of these guys. Try and hit them from a bit of a distance. Just pelt some arrows in this guy. Got him. Now, I think that was all of them that she summoned. Let's just go and have a look around our base just to make sure that there are no more. I don't think there are. Alright, so what we need to do today, guys, is pretty much get some resources developed. Oh, and there is one there. There is one right here. So let's go ahead and destroy this guy. Come here, you. And look at the head blow. Nice. And what did he have? Add some goldenrod seeds. We're going to leave those because we can get goldenrod pretty abundantly around the area. So, overnight, we've finished making our iron tools. And you can see that I now have an iron axe and an iron pickaxe, which is pretty neat. I'm going to get those all, put it in my inventory there. I've got rid of my stone axe now because I don't need it. And I'm also making some more torches. What we're going to do is we're going to look at mining today because we need some more resources pretty urgently. Now, last time we started mining in one of the gravel patches, and I believe it was this one. So let me just set a waypoint to that, and let's head over to that one. I believe that's where we started mining. I'm not sure though. If we didn't, we can always just go back and continue mining. Now, the things we need in particular are clay and stones. We also need some plant fibers and wood, but much less of it. What we want to do is get resources together so that we can start preparing to build a base. So it's definitely something that we're going to need to begin. So let's see. Did I mine any of this gravel around here or did I not? Maybe I didn't. Okay, this might be a fresh patch. But in any case, I can show you how to find ore. What you'll want to do is you'll want to look for these gravel patches on the ground. These gravel patches... Oh, there's a bird's nest there as well. Let me just get that. These gravel patches will indicate where ore is located underground. In particular, iron ore. So what we want to do is we want to start digging. We want to start digging through all this gravel here, and I'm just going to get rid of this above the bird's nest there, so we can get rid of it. And it's still not falling down. Never mind. So let's start following this gravel down and see if we can find some ore. Now, unfortunately, we only have a stone shovel right now, but the more we mine, the more our mining tools is going to increase. Now, the one thing you want to be careful of is never leave yourself no way out of a mine, because sometimes zombies can actually wander in after you, and then that's pretty much a death sentence. So make sure you're leaving yourself a little bit of a way out so that you can run to safety if you need to. So I'm just going to go ahead and dig a little bit over here so that I can make a way out right here. There we go. So now I can just walk out if I need to. That bird's nest floating there is really weird. So what we're going to do is we're going to start digging through some of this gravel here, because A, this is going to give us stones and sand, and B, it's going to lead us to iron. So we want to start digging down through here. We're going to want to eventually get some better tools though. So eventually I'm going to start using my pickaxe on some of those boulders and getting an iron shovel, because that will allow me to dig through the stuff a little bit quicker. So let's have a look down and see what we can find down here. Unfortunately though, we're now out. So let's go ahead and repair that. Nice. And we can start digging again. So yeah, digging up gravel is a good, easy way to get a lot of stone very quickly. You can now see that I already have 483 of it. I had about 300 before, so just in this short time interval, we've got like 100 and something stone pretty easily. Now, I know that I could be using the daylight hours to go out and explore, but right now, I need to get resources together so that I can actually have a base that's actually gonna stand up to zombies. Because I don't know about you, but that wooden one that we've got going on right now is just not gonna cut it. I want to be moved out into a better base pretty quickly. So now, let's venture down in here and start digging some more. Of course, trying not to get caught under here. Eventually, we'll run into iron. It does take a little bit of time, especially in the early game when you've only got a very basic shovel. But it's fine. We're going to get down there. We'll get down. Just dig through all this, and then we'll see what we can find down the bottom. Now, not always will you find ore. Sometimes you'll just find absolutely nothing. So hopefully, this is going to be a nice one. Because usually, the more gravel there is, the more of an indicator that ore is going to be down there. You know what? I'm going to make myself a better stone shovel. Let's go ahead and make a better one. So let's just go stone shovel. There we go. So let's make a better one. Because that'll only take a few seconds to make. And I'll go and scrap that old one. There we go. Gimme. There we go. 67. This will start digging a lot faster. Aha! I think I see some. Go ahead and just dig this area out here. And I think we might have got lucky. Now, unfortunately, I've not really left myself a way out of here, so I'm really quickly just going to make myself an escape tunnel so I can get back up. And the good thing is, by doing this, we're also leveling up as well. So let me just make a little escape tunnel really quick so that we can get out in an emergency, because that's always a good idea. There we go. So now we have a little area to escape from. Now, I think I see some ore right there. Let me get a torch out. I did make a lot of these now. Let me get a torch out so I can kind of show you what to look for. Now, if I just place that there, ores, as you can see, stand out a little bit. The iron ore in particular stands out from the rest of the stone and the gravel around it because it's got a nice little brown colour. Therefore, if we get our pickaxe and we start whacking on it, you can see that there is a lot of iron ore right here. Now, getting iron fragments out of this thing is going to take some time initially, but you can see we're doing a fair amount of damage to it and getting a good bit of iron out of it. Now, these things only have 1000 HP. They don't degrade into anything else like the boulders on the surface, but if you need to get a little bit more iron and you've run out of boulders on the surface, then going for these little things is quite good. Now, we're going to need a lot of iron, and in total, one of these things will drop 37 in total. You have to destroy it completely to get all 37. So let's go ahead and just get one of these. Nice. And there we go. Now, is there any way we can speed up our mining? Yes, there is. There is a perk in order to speed up the mining. And I think we should have enough skill points. We do. We got 10 skill points. So what you want to do is, if you want to speed up your mining, go and find the perk called Miner 69er. This will speed up your mining by 20% per level. So when it's all maxed out, you'll be mining twice as fast as before. So there we go. We are now mining a little bit faster. Now the effect isn't too noticeable, but you can see that it is slightly better. This will affect your pickaxe, shovel, and your regular fire axe as well. So now we can actually start mining some more of this resource out of here. Now, when you're digging through gravel, the one thing I have to say is be very careful, because gravel is not very stable. If you start digging through it too much and making little tunnels underneath it, the whole thing could fall on your head and instantly kill you. It's happened to me several times, so something I just want you guys to be mindful of. Let's go ahead and get some more gravel, as well as some iron. Get some iron first, then we'll get a bit more gravel. Nice. All right. So, in total, we have 74 of those iron fragments. I'm going to go and get a little bit more gravel, and then I'm going to meet you at the location where I want to start our new base, and we're going to start building some stuff. In the meantime, I'm also going to be collecting plant fibers as well, because we're going to need a lot of those in order to make at least a start on the base today. Now that it's day 4, we're going to get our first airdrop. In order to see where the airdrop is, you can either turn on the airdrop markers or just listen for the general direction in which the plane was flying. You'll then see a parachute in the sky, and you can see that there's a little trail leading down to it. Now, sometimes these airdrops can be pretty far away, but on the plus side, they can have some very good loot in them. So what we're going to do is we are going to venture off to find an airdrop, because I'm sure there's going to be some pretty good stuff in. And it doesn't look like it's actually too far away. This will be a good opportunity as well for me to go and find some more birds' nests and get other stuff ready that I'm going to need in order to make more arrows. So I'm going to be picking stuff up along the way as well. So let's go and see what is in this airdrop. Now, airdrops usually contain one of a few things. They can contain valuable medical supplies, such as medicine kits and antibiotics. They can also contain schematics, and sometimes even guns. So, they're pretty good. And we're back in the planes again. Nice. So the airdrop is over this way somewhere. Let's have a look and see if we can find it. So now, we've actually crossed over to the plains, and we're now in a pine forest. That biome over there is a maple forest. This one has big tall trees. This is a pine forest. However, it's pretty much just as easy to live in. There's slightly less snow breeze in the pine forest, though, so there is that to bear in mind. So the airdrop is pretty much directly over this way. Let's just run past that guy, because not interested in fighting him. I want to get that airdrop and see what we've got, because maybe it could be something we can use for the 7-day horde. However, it looks like it might be pretty far away. Usually, these things can be. There's another guy right there. Let's just run around him. Bye, guys. That's the good thing about zombies in the day. They're nice and slow, so they just can't catch you, even when you're walking like this. I mean, if things get bad, just use your bow. Let's just have a look and see how far away we are from it. Hopefully not too much further. Nope, not at all. Not too much further. Plus, it looks like there's a pathway around here, so more points of interest could be on the horizon as well. Let's have a look and see if we can find anything good around here. Nothing so far. Alrighty, guys. That biome over there is a wasteland. You can see, you can tell it's slightly different. It's like a bit more greyish. That's a wasteland over there. One that you definitely want to stay away from. Now, you can search these tree stumps as well, and sometimes you can find good things in them, including honey. Honey is a good way to cure infection if you got a stage 1 infection. However, your infection does progress after day 1. If you are in stage 2 infection or stage 3 or more, honey won't do a thing. But here we go. We're now at the airdrop. Let's have a look and see what's in here. We've got... Ah, look at this. So we've got... This is probably the most valuable thing. The first aid kit. This will save your life. Trust me. Now, we've also got a chainsaw schematic. So you can read that to learn a chainsaw. And this one is probably another one of the most valuable things. The medicine kit schematic. Or the first aid kit schematic. We can read that as well. We even got a rocket launcher receiver, although we don't really know how to craft the rocket launcher yet. So unfortunately, that's not really going to do too much for us at the current time. What I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to now head back to base. Of course, chop some things on the way and get a load of resources as we go. And I see a chicken. Come here, chicken. That'll be some feathers. Free feathers. I want them. Why, thank you. Got him. Right. So yeah, chickens. Don't give you animal hides, but if you chop them up, they give you a ton of feathers. So, definitely worth looking for chickens whenever you can spot them. I just happened to find one because it was running right in front of me. So, let me just go ahead and chop them up. Now, chickens, unlike other animals, won't leave a corpse around behind it. So, you don't need to worry about clearing that up. They'll just degrade into pretty much a block of nothing, which is pretty cool. Now, I'm going to go ahead and start chopping some more trees, getting some more resources ready, and then I'll meet you in a little bit. Alrighty guys, I'm back at base, and as you can see, my health is a little bit lower. I got hit by some nasty zombies. Oh no! So how can I heal myself? Well, there's a few things that we can use. The first option is to take pain pills. Now, pain pills will heal you a little bit over time, but they will also dehydrate you. However, I think because as we've got a load of goldenrod tea to back us up in this place, pain pills won't be such a bad thing. We can also use these first aid bandages. These will give you a little bit of a healing buff as well, and will heal you over time. You can use the med kits that we got earlier, but that's probably not a good idea. I've left those med kits right here. I will take those out for emergencies, but usually these should just be used in emergencies. Now, you can also eat food. So if I go in the campfire here and eat this charred meat, you'll see that a little acorn sign has appeared above my hunger and hydration right there. And you can see that I'm actually healing a little bit. So eating is a good way to actually restore your health. You'll have to note that drinking doesn't quite work though. Drinking doesn't restore your health, only eating. But I needed to get rid of this shard meat anyway, so let's go ahead and eat all that. And that should be enough to heal me. Only use medical supplies as and when you have to. If you don't need to use them, then come up with an alternative. Because medical supplies are more of situational and emergency uses. So definitely try and save them up when you can. Now, I do have some more iron melting up in this forge. The main reason is I would like to get some more forged iron to make a shovel. Unfortunately, I need more clay in order to be able to do that. So I'm going to go get digging some clay before it gets dark. And it seems a little wandering horde is coming through the area. You'll want to deal with wandering hordes because you can usually get some good loot out of these guys. So let's see if we can deal with some of these. Come on then, guys. Hopefully there's only this many of them, though. Come on then, you. Got him. Just duck around this guy. Down you go. Right, when wandering hordes come through the area, guys, first thing you want to do is always check for crawlers. So go back in the general direction of where they came, just check for crawlers, just in case. Because they'll sneak up on you and they might break your leg. But I don't see any crawlers right now. One might come along later, but I didn't initially see any. Now, I've also been crafting up some more iron, because what I want to do is make myself an iron shovel. Once I got an iron shovel, I'll be able to do a lot quicker digging. So I've got 19 forged iron in here, and I believe I've got one more in there. Yes, there we go. So let's go ahead and get an iron shovel, and then finally we'll be able to upgrade all of our tools. Now, the one thing you've probably been wondering is, if I don't have a stone axe anymore, how am I going to upgrade the buildings? Well, there is a better tool that you can make, the claw hammer. We're going to go ahead and get some more forged iron. But first of all, let's see how many we make, just so we don't make too much iron. We only want to get one claw hammer anyway. So the claw hammer only takes 12 forged iron, and we currently have 4. So let's go ahead and get 8 more, and then we'll be ready to make the claw hammer once that's all done. The rest of this is going to be dumped into iron arrowheads. I know I don't have that many feathers, but over time I'm going to find some more. Now, using the precious few hours of daylight that we've got left, I'm going to go and find a mining spot again, and I'm going to go and cover it over so that we can actually start mining at night without zombies falling in. So I'm going to build like a... I'm going to pick somewhere pretty much to mine. We just need stone and clay. So I think a good spot to pick is going to be this little area over here. Now, all I want to do pretty much is make sure this area is covered, because right now we've been going around and, you know, not having the best of luck with the zombies. So let's go ahead and we're probably going to want to get some wood frames and stuff on the go. But I'm going to go and see, first of all, if I have any more wood. I guess I could chop some of these trees down. Now you can see, though, now that we've purchased the minus 69er perk, that we are chopping down these trees a heck of a load faster than we were before. So we're getting a lot more wood out of these each time now than we were previously. Now, iron tools aren't the best tools you can get. You can get steel tools as well, but it's going to be a little while before you get those. There are ways to power level the system, of course, but this tutorial is not showing you how to power level. There is a very good Let's Player called Belkoff who does do power leveling and things like that. So I think Cage848 also advocates power leveling. So, you know, that's a pretty good way to get your level up, is via power leveling. Essentially, it's by crafting loads of things repeatedly in order to get skill points and level up. It does work. It does work, I have to admit. But I try and play the game without it. But it's totally up to you if you want to power level or not. And I don't want that corpse on my front porch right there. That kind of sucks. Right. I'm going to take out the rest of the clay from the forge, though, because I don't think we're going to need any of that now. So let's go ahead and take that to get our claw hammer. Take that, and now we're going to want to make our claw hammer now, and then we're going to make some more iron arrows so that we've got those already. Now, I'm going to try and keep the stone arrows for basic zombie contact and save all my iron ones for the forge. Horde Knight even, because they'll do more damage to zombies, and of course when there's a horde of zombies on me, I'd rather, you know, be a little bit better defended. Now, do I want to get the rest of that clay out, or should we leave it? I'm actually going to leave it in there. Now, let's go and see if we've got any more wood frames. We do have a few wood frames. I'm going to need to make some kind of covered area so that I can start mining. I could always expand this place out a little bit, but, you know, we're not going to be staying here for too much longer. So I think what I'll do is I will use a ladder that goes down into the ground. So currently we have to wait for our claw hammer to craft up a little bit, so I'm just going to create... like a little side area, I guess, so that we can mine down into the ground. I do need clay, though, so I'm tempted to go over there to create the mine. So, yeah, decisions that have to be made rather quickly. So, how much more of this have I got? I don't want to leave this on for too long, because otherwise it'll start attracting screamers again. And screamers aren't good. They're mean. have a look. Do I have any more stuff I can make with this? I should actually have... I think I had some more goldenrod on the way. Maybe? Yeah, here we go. More goldenrod tea. So let's go ahead and make some. Cool. So you can see pretty much as the days go on, things aren't really, you know, follow me and do this, follow me and do this. I'm just kind of trying to give you a general guide as to what to do. But in order to go and build our base, we are going to need resources. In order to get resources, we're going to need to do mining. The best time to do mining is, of course, at night when the zombies are all running, because then you could be somewhere in a covered, secluded area and not have to worry about them so much. Alrighty. Do I have my claw hammer made? I do. Just got some iron arrows to go, and then I should be all fine and dandy. So what we're going to do, I think, is we're going to... did I bring some torches? I did. Let's get the torches out, because it's getting a little bit dark. Right, so it is pretty much nighttime now. I was going to head out to the mines, but now that it's actually going to be darker at night, I'm not going to be doing any mining in a faraway location. I'm going to try, essentially, to set up a mine pretty much where I am at the moment and just try and get some stone, because stone is the main thing I need, and clay is pretty easy to get now that we've got an iron shovel. So stone is probably going to be the main bottleneck in our production of resources. So what I'm going to do first though is get a light on there, just light Sarah up a little bit better. So let's go ahead and quickly see if we can dig our way down here. And then we're going to make a ladder going down into the ground. And then we should be able to start mining from that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little hatch. Now, I haven't shown you guys hatches yet, and they're pretty cool. So hopefully I'll be able to in just a sec. So let's go ahead and dig out these little areas. I want to do this quickly before a wandering horde comes through the area. Now, we did just have one, so the chances of another wandering horde coming in straight after are pretty low. But sometimes it does happen. Believe me, it does sometimes. Now, before I continue, I want to make sure all my campfires and things are off. And let's just make sure I'm fully fed and hydrated as well. I may as well go and do that, just to be sure. Am I hungry? Yes. So yeah, you can see though, by keeping on top of your character's needs, your wellness gradually goes up, which is definitely a cool thing. Right, let's go ahead and get some more frames. I think, actually no, what we're going to need is a wood hatch. So let's just type, okay, I think it might just be called a hatch then. There you go. Oh, it's a wooden hatch. That's why. Okay, let's craft a wooden hatch. And then we're also going to need some ladders as well. So let's go ahead and say ladder. So we're going to need like three of these. Not too many, because the way we're going to mine is going to be pretty easy. So let's go ahead and do this. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a light and put it here, just so we can see what we're doing a little bit. And now that we've got the claw hammer, we can actually upgrade things in one shot. So the stone axe would take four shots, the claw hammer takes one. How cool is that? That is pretty neat. Now what we're going to do is we are going to now dig our way under the ground and see if we can start a mine down here. We could always dig over and tunnel over to the clay later. So I want my iron shovel so I can scrap my stone one now. Get some of that stone back. And let's dig one more layer into the ground here. And then I'm going to go ahead and dig just down here. Now, usually I don't advise digging under your base. However, because this base is so tiny, as long as we're careful, it'll be fine. We won't have to worry. Right, now that we're down underground, let's get our ladders and our hatch laid down. So we can get some ladders. Let's put the pain pills there. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to dig this little bit out here too. Like that. And then we are going to put some frames, the last two that we actually own, here and here. And then we'll just, we may as well just not bother upgrading them. We don't need to. Then I'm going to put the ladders here. And now what you can do is to climb a ladder, just approach it and then press up on your, press W and you'll climb the ladder. Pretty neat. Now what we can do is get a hatch and put it over the top. So let's go ahead and grab one of those, and then I'll put the hatch like that. And now what we can do is we can come down here, close the hatch, we're now safe, and then we can start mining under here, which is pretty neat. So let's go ahead and place a torch down here. I'm probably going to need to clear out a little bit more room before I can actually go ahead and dig some more out here. So I want to make sure, though, that I'm not compromising too much of the structural integrity of my base. So if I dig too much out of this, the whole base is going to come falling down, and I don't want that to happen. So when you're digging under your base, just be very, very careful, and only do it if you know exactly what you're doing. Otherwise, I'd recommend making a separate mining outpost somewhere else. But I think, for now, we should be fine. So I'm going to just slap a torch, like, somewhere on here, if it's going to want to let me place one. There we go. It wants me to put one there. Okay, that's cool. So now we can see what we're doing. I'm going to start going down into the earth and probably towards where the clay patch is over there. And I'm going to start mining. So let's go this way. And now that we're underground, we're nice and safe from the zombies. They can't get us down here. Especially now that the area is all blocked off as well, which is going to help. Now, by doing this digging, we're also going to get some dirt fragments. We're not going to need those right now, but they can be useful later if you need to replace some of the ground. So what I'm going to do now is start going diagonally this way and down. And then we'll be able to gradually worm our way underground and get to the stone layer. So getting to the stone layer is going to be important because we need a lot of stone for the base that we want to build a little bit later on. So stone is good. We're going to need a lot of it. So doing this as well, as I said, is going to increase your mining tools. So eventually you'll start digging faster. Now, if your tools break, you can just fix them with forged iron. So they're pretty easy to fix when you know how. So now it's getting a little bit dark, so we're going to have to put some lights down here to keep us lit up. So now you can see why I made all those lights earlier, because they're pretty useful. You can see our iron shovel is already running out of durability right now. Right, let's go ahead and put a light down here so that we can see a little bit of what we're doing. Hopefully we are near the stone layer. Yes, we are. So now we're at the stone layer, we just need to start using our pickaxe instead. Nice. So let's use our pickaxe and start getting some stone. Now, you don't destroy it very quickly, but, you know, it's not too bad. So you'll get a lot of stone this way. You'll even get a few iron fragments for destroying each piece of stone as well. It's not much, but it's better than nothing. Each piece of stone will get you 25 small stones once you've destroyed it completely. So get a few of these. You're going to want quite a bit in order to build a type of base, in order to build an effective base. You'll definitely want stone for your base material rather than wood, because zombies tear through wood like cardboard. They really do. But stone is a lot more resistant. So I'm going to be showing you that base build in the next episode. For now, though, I've got a lot of mining to do. And in that case, I think it's a good time to end off the tutorial. So I hope you enjoyed this segment, and I will see you in part 5. So until then, bye!